hey, here's one representation of what Hurricane Ian might do to Florida, where I live, which is going to hit tomorrow. And it shows this single line, and we get a sense, oh, well, we know what the hurricane's going to do. It's going to follow this line, and it's going to hit here and exactly here. But the hurricane's approach is much more probabilistic than that. Here's a better representation where we show a cone where the hurricane can go. This is even better because this is showing a very wide cone. You can see the whole state of Florida is covered because this is saying, hey, where are 40 knot winds or greater likely to be? And you can see here, oh, if I live like, oh, 1 inch outside of the cone, I'm safe. I don't need to worry about it. This I like the best. It's showing discrete tracks. Even the weathermen refer to this as the spaghetti tracks. From a model, each track is discrete, but there are a whole number of them, and we're not claiming to know at this point which of these particular tracks it's going to follow. Representing future events as probabilistic and not binary and deterministic is very important because then it allows people to talk in a probabilistic way, which allows them to say things like, I'm not really sure, I'm only 80% or 20% or 5% sure that we're doing the wrong thing, but I'd like to bring it up. If we force people into are you sure sort of thinking, and well, where is the hurricane going to go, then we get a lot less communication and thinking from the group, and it makes it much harder for them to share their probabilistic thoughts. I'm David Marquet. That's your Leadership Nudge. This, not that.